Choreograph tutorial, how to program motion and speech in a Python script. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make NAO perform coordinated hand, arm, and head motions while saying a greeting. A good way to start is to first look at some of the existing Python scripts in the box libraries. Here we have three boxes, set language and say of the audio voice library and hands of the motions library. We shall focus our attention on the last two, say and hands, because they contain quite simple Python scripts. In the hands box, the user can choose an action such as close or open the hand. Let's choose open. The say box is a group which we can enter by double clicking inside. Inside, we find a box called Localized Text, which allows the user to key in the text to be said in a given language. Next to it is the Say Text box. We'll come back to it later. Let's upload the behavior to the virtual robot. We can see that at the start of the behavior, the robot opens its hands and say the greeting text simultaneously. Suppose now we want the robot to close its hands. Let's do so by changing the action parameter. To start the hands behavior again, we simply double-click on the input button on its left. There. Now we want to open just the left hand. This is done by setting the action parameter to close again, and also the side parameter to left instead of both. Start the behavior again. The hands box actually contains a Python script, which we can open in the editor by double-clicking the box. The script on the right may look complicated at the moment, but we can look for clues as to how the behavior is executed. Here, we see a line that contains a function .openHand and another .closeHand. Clearly, the hand motions are controlled by either of these functions. They take as input parameter a string which can be LHand or RHand, as we can see a few lines above. These must be specific names associated with the robot's mechanical structure. We also see other lines that contain the function .getParameter. It is used to read in box parameters that we have been manipulating manually a while ago. The say box contains a Python script similar in structure. In it, we can also see some clues as to how a text is turned into speech. First, we see a string is assigned to the variable sentence, which is then passed to a function .say. These two examples tell us about some of the built-in library functions that we can use in our own Python program to create motions and speech. We shall now create a new script. Instead of starting from scratch, we can pick up a template from the library. Drag the Python script box into your behavior and double-click to open the script in the editor. We can see a skeleton script, which tells us what the standard structure looks like. In object-oriented programming, this script defines a class with four functions or methods: init, onload, onUnload, on input on start, and on input on stop. To know which functions we should write our main codes, let's go back to the hands example. There, we can see that most of the script is found in the function on input on start. So we know that we have to write up this function in our new script. The on input on start function is actually executed when a signal is received at an input port found on the left of the box. That input is called onStart, which is precisely the same name as that of the function after the underscore. So, by sending a signal or double-clicking the onStart port, we are actually starting the behavior defined by its corresponding function. Similarly, the function onInputOnStop is executed when a signal is received at a second input port. Not surprisingly, the port is called onStop. Let's start with a simple hand motion. First, we declare an object dartMotion, which is an instance of the built-in library module called ALMotion. It provides the main functions that make the robot move. We declare this library object in the function onLoad, so that this is done once and for all when the behavior is loaded. Now, in the function onInputOnStart, we add two lines with the .openHand and .closeHand functions. Notice that the string lHand is passed to these two functions, so the robot should open then close its left hand. Load the behavior and double-click the OnStart button. The robot does what we have expected. Next, we want to make the robot open and close both hands. Instead of repeating the previous two lines, we use a for loop. First, declare an empty array called hands. Then append the strings lHand and rHand to the array. Put the openHand and closeHand functions in a for loop and pass them the placeholder hand. Since in the for loop, hand takes the values lHand and rHand consecutively, we now expect the robot to open and close both hands. Load and start the behavior. We can see that the hand motions are done one after the other. First the left hand, then the right hand. This is because the script in the for loop is executed consecutively. Suppose now we want to make both hands open and close simultaneously. This can be done by simply calling the open hand and close hand functions using post. The post attribute is used to call functions in the background. This will let you make the robot do several things at the same time. Behavior started with post becomes so-called non-blocking, meaning that the other behaviors would not wait for them to end. If you want to wait for the hands to stop moving before doing something else, we can use the wait function. First, declare an empty array called IDS. Next, each post call returns a task ID. So for each of our post call, we append the task ID to the array. Finally, we call the wait function on each of these IDs in a for loop. Besides the hands, the ALMotion module provides ways to control other parts of the robot's body. To know more, simply navigate via the Help menu to API Reference. This contains the documentation of the application programming interface for the robot's software architecture, nicknamed NAOqi. At this moment, we are interested in the ALMotion API, so we follow this link. In this page, we recognize the function openHand and closeHand. There are many APIs for joint control, locomotion control, etc. We'll check out this particular one, angle interpolation. Let's follow the link. As it says in the description, this function interpolates joints along timed trajectories. In other words, this function generates continuous joint motions that go through a few angles at specific timings. We jump straight to a Python example below. Here, 8 motions in the yaw and pitch joints are programmed. The first join, head yaw, is required to go through 50 degrees at the 1 second mark, and then end at 0 degree at the 2 second mark. This is set up in the first parts of the array's angle lists and time lists. Similarly, the second join, head pitch, is required to go through 3 other angles at 3 other timings. Notice that the joint trajectories can be specified independently of each other, as shown by the different highlight colors. To find out more about the different joints that can be controlled this way, go to the NAO documentation page and follow the link Actuator and Sensor List. We can see a total of 25 joints for NAO. Among this, we recognize rHand and lHand belonging to the right and left arms, and also head pitch and head yaw belonging to the head. Be sure to check out what motion each of these joints produce and the range of values of the actuators and sensors. Back to the example, the function angle interpolation is called by passing it the three arrays containing the names of the joints to move, the angles for each joint, and the corresponding timing. We now apply what we've learned to our script. We shall make the head pitch joint move to 0.2 radians at the 1 second mark and to 0 radians at the 2 second mark. So the robot should nod its head once. We place this code before those of the hand motions. As you can see, the robot nods its head before moving its hand. This is because we have not caught angle interpolation using post. Let's do so now. As a result, head nod and hand motions are now simultaneous. Let's spice things up a little bit. First, we declare an instance of the AL text-to-speech module in the onload function. Then, in the onStart function, we include say, which is a method of text-to-speech. We simply pass to it a string of text. Next, we are going to generate more motion using the angle interpolation method by adding the joint R-elbow-row. It will go through three angles at different timings, 90 degrees twice and 0 degree. With this, we expect now to raise its right forearm like a handshake gesture. All the motions and speech functions are caught with pose, so they are all performed simultaneously. There you have it. I hope this tutorial gets you started in writing your own Python scripts for motions and speech. Be sure to check out the documentation on other joints and actuators, and also other motion and speech API modules. You may also want to think about controlling motions with dynamic input, such as pointing at an object that now sees in its vision. More about this and the Vision API in future videos. Happy scripting!